Very good morning to all the students of class plus 2C. I was expecting that many students will come, but see, class plus 2, maybe after getting the date sheet, they don't want to study or what? You have to be very, very serious now to attend all the classes. So yes, two more students coming in. We will be revising chapter Deep Water. Today is your test day, so I will be sharing test in the evening rather than now. We can revise one more chapter today, okay? So Deep Water is the next, and then we will move to poetry. Poetry also we have done, then we'll move to another book next week, okay? So Deep Water, this chapter, you know, this actually is an extract. Basically, you have to remember each and every detail about the chapter. This is an extract which is taken from the book Men and Mountains. Fine, this is clearly mentioned here. You can see. Of Men and Mountains. So from this books by William O. Douglas, this is the main character of your chapter Deep Water. So narrator of the story and the main character or the protagonist and the writer, they all are same. So William O. Douglas is the protagonist and he himself is the pivotal character of this narration. So this is kind of autobiographical account of the narrator. Fine, so Of Men and Mountains, he has taken this extract from. So one book he has written in which he has mentioned that how as a young boy, William Douglas, and we will be using the word Douglas only for this, but the complete name is William Douglas, that how he had drowning experience in swimming pool and how he had formed aversion of water, right? And how he overcame that aversion. So when you remember, when you did this chapter, then also we were taking online classes. At that time, I asked one question, remember? That tell me your phobias and tell me your aversions. And you told me that some people are scared of height. Some people are scared of any creatures and animals and darkness. So everybody has one or the other aversion. So this chapter tells us that rather than escapism, rather than running away from the situation, you have to face your fear and conquer it. Because when you face your fear, then there is no more fear left. The having the feeling of fear is the biggest fear only. So this is to be proved by William Douglas in this story, that how he discusses the aversion of water. And always there is a root cause, that these aversions are formed with a root cause in the childhood days only. Fine, ki kaise bachpan mein you just form that aversion and how it leads to more, it takes more grave form in the later days if you are not assisted. So it happened. It happened when I was 10 or 11 years old. It here means that aversion, that fear that started forming, fine? When I here means William Douglas, clear? So I won't be reading. This is not the reading chapter. We are revising only. So I'll just be making you understand that this is the journey of overcoming the aversion to water and which is deeply rooted in the childhood days of the narrator William Douglas. So firstly, he mentioned, so this is the incident when he was 10 or 11 years old and he decided to learn to swim. So there was a pool at YMCA in Yakima and there they were giving the opportunity to learn to swim. And Yakima River was very treacherous, very dangerous. So his mother, this was an MCQ based question, but I will be sharing many questions with you after the discussion of the chapter in the group. So mother continually warned the author that you should not go to Yakima River. This is very dangerous. Many people have drowned over there actually. So that's why she decided ki you should go to YMCA pool. This is safe for you rather than going to Yakima River. You should prefer going to YMCA pool, which is safe. And it is 2-3 feet deep. In the beginning, you will learn to swim. So he got a pair of water wings and then he reached to that pool at the age of 10 or 11. Okay, is it clear? So then Yakima River map, you can see this is very dangerous. Many people have died over there, drowned over there. Fine. Then we have from the beginning. Now, author is telling us that how he formed the aversion. So he was having this aversion from the beginning. And this started when I was 3 or just mark it, just remember 3 or 4-year-old. This incident you have to remember now first. So he is going to narrate that incident when he was 3 or 4 year old. He was a young boy and his father took him to the beach in California. So he lives in California. His father took him to beach. He was standing with his father for surfing. You know, various water sports are there, but he was just standing over there. Water waves are coming and going, and one of the, you can say, heavy water wave just knocked him down and water ran over him. He was buried in water. His breath was gone and he was very scared. He was scared to bones. Means wo bahut zyada dar gaya tha. So overpowering force of the waves. And that was the beginning when aversion of water was formed. So now it is in our hands how we handle the kids. If had his father, you know, his father was like not serious at that time because he never thought that my son is going to get this aversion for lifetime. Clear? And see, this is to be highlighted here. Father laughed, but there was terror in my heart at the overpowering force of the waves. Sometimes we start laughing casually, but we do not realize the gravity of situation. He was forming that phobia at that point. If I fall into the water, I can die, I can drown, anything can happen. And rather than making him stand and making him understand that this is just one coincidence and you can swim and all, father started laughing. So that was the beginning of his terror, you should remember. Now, beta, now we are going to talk about YMCA pool. Here, my introduction to the YMCA pool, he is going to tell that when he joined that pool, what happened, that incident of that when a boy dugged him into the water. So he had unpleasant memories associated with YMCA pool. Why? Anybody can tell me that? Which incident I'm going to narrate? Anyone? क्लास में तो वैसे ही नहीं बोलते हो ऑनलाइन क्लास में लेट्स सी इफ एनीबॉडी इज एबल टू एनीबॉडी कैन रिकॉल दैट इंसिडेंट व्हेन अ बिग बुली बॉय ही केम आई एम गिविंग यू द हिंट्स आल्सो सुखमन जो देर रिमेंबर काफी देर बाद आए हो क्लास अटेंड करने याद है आपको डीप वॉटर यस यू कैन स्पीक Srishti, Raghav, Sukhman Jod, Rana Gurji, there are many students, they are not speaking up. Raise your hand. Very easy question I'm asking. Do participate. Which incident? In one line you can tell me. I will narrate the incident, but you have to tell me which incident. YMCA pool, what happened over there? It is written in front of you on the screen only. I don't know why you are hesitant of speaking. So I went to the pool when no one else was there. The place was quiet. So what happened? He went to learn to swim over there. And water was very clean as a bathtub we use at home. He was timid about going in alone. So he was very scared. It was his first day of swimming and he thought I should wait. I should sit over there. I had not been there long. He was just sitting there. That incident now, which was the root cause of the major phobia formation, a big bruiser of a boy, a big bully, that boy came probably 18 years old. So this is the not exactish probably. So narrator has just made an estimation. So he was just a teenager, an 18 year old boy. He had thick hair, beautiful physical specimen with legs and arms, a strongly built boy. वहाँ पे आता है and he says to the narrator Douglas क्या कहते हैं Hi skinny, how do you like to be dugged? How would you like to be dugged? So before Douglas could react, he picked him up, he tossed him deep into the water and he landed in a sitting position. अब जिस बच्चे को swimming नहीं आता है, he has come there for the first time, he does not know anything about swimming, he was thrown into the water, he was landing in a sitting position. Water he was swallowing and he was frightened and not yet frightened out of my wits. What does it mean out of wits? Matlab out of senses. He was saying, but though I was into the water, but still my mind was working. He started making plans that when I will reach the bottom of the swimming pool, I will make a big jump, I will come to the surface and I will try to paddle to the pool. I will try my level best. So he was making a plan while drowning. So he was not out of his wits. But kehna aur karna, do different baat hai. So it is quite a big difference. When it seemed a long way down, underline this, 9 feet were more like 90. So 9 feet, 9 feet bhi bahut hai. We normal human being is 5-6 feet. 5 feet something, normal average height, five would be average. So 9 feet was also, you can say, excuse me, quite big for a boy. So 90, and before I touched bottom, my lungs were ready to burst. Why? Because it takes a lot of water was going inside. He doesn't know the tricks to inhale and exhale into the water. So, but when my feet hit the bottom, I summoned all my strength and made what I thought was a great spring, but what he thought did not happen. It is not that easy. Fine. So again, he was drowning. He grew panicky. His hands, you know, when you do not get that breathing, his hands were moving. He was trying to grab the rope. He was trying to grab the water. He started suffocating. He was trying to yell, chilla raha tha, but no sound was coming out. And his water was into his eyes, his nose, but not my mouth. I flailed at the surface of the water, swallowed and choked. So he was choking. Fine. Not able to breathe. Again, he tried. He was feeling the weights. He was feeling as if he's paralyzed. Paralyzed, he's not able to move his arms and legs. So his body was becoming rigid, stiff. Again, a great force was pulling him under. Why? Because he does not know the art of swimming yet. So again, he was drowning. And again, he thought of making another effort. Fine. Again, he expending my strength as one in a nightmare flights. Nightmares, when you sometimes have nightmares, bures khwab, then you think that you are drowning, you are dying, but you are trying to save yourself, but nothing is happening. So he's thinking as if I was watching a nightmare that was happening to me. He was getting dizzy. Fine. Dizziness means when you lose your senses. Behosh hona. But I remembered the strategy. Again, he was not out of his wits. He remembered the strategy. I would spring from the bottom. Again, he thought, ki jab main niche pahunchunga, I will hit the bottom. Again, I will like a cork of a bottle. I'll try to hit myself up and I lie flat and strike out with my arms and I will come out. But I went down and down and down. Nothing but water, the yellow glow. Now he says he admitted this thing, stark terror. Sheer terror, grave terror seized him, gripped him. He knows no understanding, terror that knows no control, terror that no one can understand. Fine. So I'm sending you quickly. I have this list of questions. If you can, side by side, I don't know whether you have same devices, you can use the meeting or what, but I have some questions with me based on the same. So you will give me the answer to this in between, okay? These are the questions based on what we have read so far. See, in the assignments group I'm sending, so that I need not speak again and again the same questions, you can go through and you can answer. But better do participate. Do participate. Don't sit in a dumb way. You're not responding at all. So I have, see, first question, who is the author of Deep Water? Very easy one. Just raise your hand and speak. Yes, Sukhmanjot, beta bolo.
William Douglas.
Yes,
William
Douglas. Yes, William Douglas. I have sent the questions to you all. Jinko beta visible hai. Fine. Question I will speak here also. Second question is, in which subject has the author graduated? It is in the beginning of the book. Beginning of the chapter, sorry. In which subject has the author graduated? English and history, English and science, science and social studies, English and economics. Though you are reading from the book, books se read karke do, but do give the answer. You should know the answer. In which subject has the author graduated? See, this question you never expected, but it is written. in the assignment. Yes, anybody? Raise your hand, everyone. Srishti is there, Lakshit is there, Prabhnoor Kaur, Rana Gurjeet, Rasika, Samyak, bol nahi raha yahan pe. Do participate, beta. These questions I is just sending for you people. Do you have book with you? Ye lijiye. Book bhi nahi kholni humne. So we are too lazy to open that. Anji. English and Economics. This is mentioned. Bachelor of Arts in English and Economics. Clear? This is the option D. So you do not want to put in efforts in anything. That's so bad. So next question is, for how many years had the author taught in high school in Yakima? What is the answer to this? See, otherwise I'm not going to ask the question. I'll just straight away in a boring way that will go. I'll keep on giving the lecture. You do not participate at all. Plus 2C. Prabhu is entering. Yes, jaldi se. Any question? Fourth one, after the author was fed up with teaching, he decided to opt for which career? Okay, the story speaks about fear of water and the way to overcome it, fear of swimming and how to overcome it, fear of people or fear of, they have written dogs, but that will be not that easy, fear of or facing one's aversions. Yes, Srishti, ye option maine change kar di either. So it's about swimming only, or it's about all the aversions? You tell me, any of you. Yes, Rishi, you can speak.
Ma'am, it's about all the aversions.
Yes, so basic theme is about, so this question can be confusing. Some children will think this is all about swimming and all. But actually, this is about facing one's aversions and how to overcome them. So this is the theme. Fine. So let's continue. I will send more questions to you soon. So stay tuned for that. Okay. Then he tried again, but his stomach was hurting. He started vomiting. The next thing he remembered, thrice he turned to save his life. He thought of the same plan again and again, but he could not. And next thing what he saw was, he was out of the pool. He was lying on his stomach. Somebody was trying to save his life. He was vomiting. And chap, the chap means boy, casual language mein bol dete hain. He was saying, I was only fooling. So that big bully, that boy, the big, good muscular body he was having, that 18-year-old boy, he was saying to someone that I was just fooling. The kid nearly died. Be all right now. Let's carry him to the locker room. So somebody was saying, you are fooling around. This is not a joke. The kid almost died. So marne se bacha author. You can say that he had such a bad experience of swimming that he formed that aversion. Several hours later, I walked home. So what happened aftermath of that? That he walked home. He was very weak. He was trembling. He was crying. He was shaking with fear. He did not have his food. He felt wobbly. Wobbly is very weak in his stomach. He was like, that was the worst thing happened to a 10 or 11 year old boy who wanted to learn to swim, and very bad experience the very first day only. So that was the reason of aversion. So now he's going to talk about that, how he learned swimming after that. Clear? His parents, they started, you know, they were having their, during holidays, they would go for fishing and water sports and canoeing and boating. But he was so, he never went for swimming, never went for boating, never went for canoeing or any water sports. Even fishing trips he missed because he had severe aversion of water, but it held him firmly in its grip. So this is the date, remember, 1st October. So finally, 1st October, I decided to get an instructor and learn to swim. So that was the day when he decided, ki no, I have to overcome. you know, you can only overcome your phobias. Nobody can help you in that. So he decided that, yes, I will overcome, but by hiring an instructor. He started learning to swim. He went to a pool. He practiced 5 days a week, 1 hour each day. It means 5 hours in 1 week. So what was the way? Now you have to remember that instructor put a belt around him. Fine. First of all, he would put safety belt. So he was very scared. Now he should not be worried. Okay, belt is there. A rope attached to the belt, went through a pulley, then ran on the overhead cable. So one hand end of the rope will be in the hand of the trainer. Then he was taught back and forth movement. Fine. Then inhaling and exhaling into the water. Clear. Then after that, he was taught how to kick outside the water firstly, because you need a lot of stamina of kicking legs in the water. So firstly, his stamina was built. He learned the art of kicking outside. Hundreds of times his trainer would ask him. And when he was perfect in different parts, jab usko kick karna aa gaya, inhaling, exhaling, back and forth movement, then all the parts put together, then he started learning to swim piece by piece. He built a swimmer. Beautiful line. Right? So piece by piece, he was taught how to swim. When he had perfected each piece, he put them together into integrated whole. In April, on 1st October, he joined Learn to Swim, that by an instructor. In April, October, November, December, January, February, March. It took 6 to 7 months. But then his trainer said, now you can swim, dive off and swim the length of the pool. Crawl stroke. Crawl stroke is the basic stroke of swimming, in which just like a baby, you have to crawl. So I did, the instructor was finished. So he did. Now instructor's job is done. Fine, he taught him the basic swimming, the various strokes, inhaling, exhaling, kicking, back, forth, whatever movements are involved in swimming. There are many strokes, crawl stroke, back stroke, butterfly stroke, chest stroke, if you read it. He was taught everything, but now instructor was finished, but I was not finished. Very beautiful line again. I was not finished means I was not sure whether I have learned swimming or not, unless and until I do it all alone. So he was again terror-stricken. Whenever he would go, itna zyada dar tha, he was again terror-stricken. Tiny vestiges. Means chote-chote dar ki jo feeling thi, again it was coming. The old terror would return back. Clear? So, look, trying to scare me. So this is the dialogue, beta, you need to remember again. Whenever he was trying to swim all alone, the old terror would come back and he would say, trying to scare me? Well, here is to you. Look, and off I would go on another length of the pool. So he was giving intrinsic motivation, means apne aap ko andar se motivate karna. So that was the thing he was doing. He was talking to his fear, shedding it away, and then finally Wentworth in New Hampshire. You need to remember this. In Wentworth, in New Hampshire, dived off a dock at Triggs Island. Fine. Bitta, please keep on underlining. New Hampshire at Triggs Island. He swam 2 miles across the lake to Stampact Island. Now, which strokes he tried into these places? Crawl, breaststroke, side stroke, backstroke. Only once did the terror return. Ek bar usko dard dobara se wapis aaya. When I was in the middle of the lake, he put his face under the water and saw bottomless water. So again, that terror seized him. Then again, he gave intrinsic motivation to himself. Mr. Terror, what do you think you can do to me? It fled and I swam on. So he was giving motivation and positive words to himself. If we keep on saying, I cannot do, you will not do. If we say, yes, I can do, you'll definitely do. Fine. So he had residual doubts now. Jo thode bahut doubts reh gaye the. So he went to Titan, to Conrad. These are the names you have to remember, that which places he swam across to make sure that he has learned. So I have highlighted this. You can see. Fine, underline this. These names you have to remember. Now, The experience had a deep meaning for me, as only those who have known stark terror and conquered it can appreciate. In death, there is peace, there is terror only in the fear of death. Roosevelt, all we have to fear itself. Roosevelt D is a writer, he has said that all we have to fear is fear itself. Hame kisi cheez se darne ki zarurat nahi, we need to fear of the fear itself only, right? Because I had experienced both the sensation of dying, and he's saying that when you die, there is no terror, because after death, you're not going to feel anything. So in death, there is peace. Terror is in your life only. So you have to live life in a good way, in a bold way. If any terror sees you, you have to stop it. You have to overcome it by facing it, by not running away from the situation. At last, I felt released, free to walk the trails and climb the peaks and to brush aside fear. So now, after swimming various places, Lake Wentworth in New Hampshire, then various islands he went, wherever he could find water bodies, all the names are mentioned. Then he realized that, yes, now my trainer's job is done. Even I all alone can swim. Once or twice, terror did seize him, but he, with his intrinsic motivation, with his strong determination, he overcame the feeling of fear. Fine. Now tell me, Vita, is it clear? Any doubt to anyone? Send me thumbs up for this. I'll be noting down the attendance of all those, only those who are present. From the beginning till the end, for the sake of attendance, those who joined, I won't be marking you present. Okay. So, those who are present, they are Raghav, Lakshet, Prabnur, Rana Gujit, Rasika, Samyak, Srishti, Jagraj, Sukhmanjot. Fine. See, rest of are enjoying maybe the holiday. I'm putting the messages, they are not responding. So now, beta, I guess we have time ho chuka hai. We have 2 minutes, but I'm sending you the assignment. Okay, so you are supposed to go through the questions. If you have any doubt, we will discuss. I have sent you 6 questions first. Fine, I'm going to send you 25 questions. So go through all the questions based on this chapter only, on deep water only, clear? And make sure you know all the answers. If you have doubt, you can ask me, fine, in the class we will discuss, or you can also text me accordingly. And your test is in the evening today. I will be sending you, it is compulsory for all, whether you attended the class or not, it is compulsory, tell them all. I'll put in the message in the group and PDF. I will be sending a PDF. You have to edit the PDF by marking the correct option over there and rename it and send it back to me. Is it clear? Rather than writing and all, I will be sending you 10 MCQs. Fine. And you will mark on the MCQ itself. You will pick the correct option, rename with your name, class and roll number, and then you will send back to me. Okay. Fine, beta. Yes. So 10:45 ho chuke hain.